Hello everyone, welcome to the next session on operations research. In this session, we will solve the third and last numerical on simplex method. Solve the following LPP using the simplex method. The problem is of minimization type. Z is equal to x1 minus 3x2 plus 3x3 subject to these three constraints. Here we have three variables, be careful, and also three constraints. X1, X2, X3 are greater than or equal to 0. This is the non-negativity constraint. So for solving, we will start by writing minimize Z is equal to X1 minus 3X2 plus 3X3. Subject to constraints 3X1 minus X2 plus 2X3. Left side is lesser, so I'll add plus S1 is equal to 7. For the second constraint, 2x1 plus 4x2, the left side is greater, so I will subtract s2 is equal to minus 12. And the last one is minus 4x1 plus 3x2 plus 8x3, left side is lesser, so plus s3 is equal to 10. Non-negativity constraint x1, x2, s3, s1, s2, s3, all are greater than or equal to 0. Now I will substitute say x1, x2 and x3 all as 0. If I substitute this 1, 2 and 3 as 0, I will get the value of s1 as 7. From the second one, I will directly get s2 is equal to 12 because both have minus sign. So what remains is s2 is 12 and s3 will be equal to 10. So these three will now be the non-basic variable. And this is my basic variable for the problem. And this total is called as initial basic feasible solution. So I will substitute in the initial simplex table to see what is the solution. So first I'll make the initial simplex table. I'll start with CBI, CJ. Basic variable, here I will have S1, S2, S3. As these three are the basic variable, the coefficient will be 0. Now where is the 0? It is in this equation of Z. Next I'll write here X1, X2, X3, S1, S2, S3. Here I'll have Zj, here is solution, and finally Cj minus Zj. Here I have to fill up the coefficient of these terms. So the first one is 1 minus 3 plus 3. This will be obviously 0. In this space, I will be writing the coefficients of these terms. So it is 3 minus 1. 2. This will be 1, 0, 0, and the value is 7. For the next equation, this is 2, 4, minus 1. This is not present, so these are 0, and this is 12. Okay, so this side is minus 12, be careful. Next is minus 4, 3, 8. This is 1, 0, 0 and the last value is 10. Now I can calculate Zj. All of them will be 0 because these three are 0. This is very easy. 1 minus 0, 1. This is minus 3. This will be 3, 0, 0, 0. The problem is of minimization type. So all the values should be greater than or equal to 0. So since all Cj minus Zj, they should be greater than or equal to 0, which it is not. Therefore, optimality is not reached. So now what happens is we have to figure out the negative value. So that is minus 3. And hence this is going to enter the solution. I need to calculate the ratio. 7 upon minus 1 is minus 7. This is going to be minus 3. And this is 10 by 3, that is 3.33. So I'll take the positive value, which is the minimum one. And I'm going to use this as the entering variable, that is S3. So this is going to be the leaving variable. So therefore, X2 is entering variable. And S3 is leaving variable. So now let's make the iteration 1 table. We start with CBI, CJ, basic variable. So in the basic variable column, you'll have S1, S2, X2. X1, X2, X3, S1, S2, S3. Then you have solution. These two are 0. The value of X2 is minus 3. And then we'll write down the coefficients. 1, minus 3, 3. This is 0, 0, 0. Now we will start with the key element. This is in the third row, so I'll divide each element by 3. So we will have minus 4 by 3. This is 1. 8 by 3. And the last value is 10 by 3. These two will become 0 under X2 column. So this is 0, 0. Next, we'll figure out these values. So for the first one, it is 3 minus 4 into minus 1 upon 3. So this 3, this 2 are plus, so this will still remain minus 4 by 3. 9 minus 4 is 5 by 3. Also, I'll calculate this value. So this is 2 minus, corresponding value is 4 and minus 4. So it is 4 into minus 4 by 3. 2 minus, this will become plus 16 by 3. This is 6 plus 16 by 3, that is 22 by 3. So this will be 22 by 3. Accordingly, I will calculate the other values now. Now I calculate ZJ. That is this into this plus 0 into 22 by 3 and this into this. So this becomes just 4. This is minus 3, minus 8. This is 0, 0, minus 1. And this is minus 10. So now we'll calculate CJ minus ZJ. This will be minus 3. This is 0. This is 11. 0, 0, 1. So we are solving for minimization type, where all values should be greater than or equal to 0. So we will be taking into account that number which is negative, like we did in the previous case. So X2 was negative. Now here you have X1 negative. So this is going to enter the solution. This is the entering variable. Now I'll calculate ratio over here. So this is 31 by 3 divided by 5 by 3. So this is 31 by 5. This is minus 76 by 22. And this is 10 divided by minus 4. So this will be the one which we are going to consider. This will be minus 2.5. This is going to be minus 3.45. Again, we are not considering the negative values. So what remains is 31 by 5, that is 6.2. So the one which is going to leave the solution is S1. So I'll write down, since all Cj minus Zj are not greater than equal to 0, therefore optimality is not reached. The value which is entering is x1. X1 is entering variable, and the one which is leaving is s1. S1 is the leaving variable. Now we need to go for iteration 2. So I'll make the next table for iteration 2. We start with CBI, CJ, basic variable. Here we have x1, x2, x3, s1, s2, s3. Then we have solution. Here we have x1, s2, x2. Be careful when you're writing. I'll enter these values. It is 1 minus 3, 3, 0, 0, 0. So this will be 1, this will be minus 3, and this is 0. Then we have to calculate Zj and Cj minus Zj. If you observe here, this is the key element 5 by 3. So I'll divide each element by 5 by 3. The first value will be 1, the next will be 0. The first is 1, this will be 0. This will be 14 by 3 divided by 5 by 3, so it is 14 by 5. This will be 1 divided by 5 by 3, so 3 by 5. This will be 0. This is 1 by 3 divided by 5 by 3, so it is 1 by 5. And this is 1 by 5. Now, here if you observe, this is the key row. So these two values directly I'll write 0. Next I'll solve for this element 0. If you observe, this value is 0. So it is very easy, because if you multiply, it is directly going to give you answer 0. So this still remains 0, and the one below it has value 1. So it is again going to remain 1. Similarly, you can observe this is 0. So these two will remain the same, S2. Minus 1 and 0. I just have to calculate the rest of them. I'll start with this term over here, 8 by 3. So this will be 8 by 3 minus, multiply these two. three gets cancelled. It is 8 by 3 minus 22 into 14 divided by 15. So this will be 8 5s are 40 minus, this is 308 divided by 15. So this becomes minus 268 upon 15. The next value is here, 8 by 3. And this is 14 by 3 and minus 4 by 3. So this will be 8 by 3 minus, and minus will make it plus. So you have 14 into 4, 3 and 3. And this is multiplied by 5 by 3. So 1, 3 gets cancelled. So this is 8 by 3 plus 56 by 15. So this becomes 40 plus 56 by 15. So this becomes 96 by 15. Now we'll calculate for the rest. So these are the values that I obtained. Next I'll calculate Zj. 1 into 1 plus 0 into 0 and this into this. So what remains is 1. This is 0, 0, minus 3. This is 14 by 5. The second one is 0. And last is minus 96 into 3 by 15. So this becomes 5. So you have 14 minus 96. That is minus 82 by 5. And here what remains is 31 by 5. Minus 174 into 3 by 15. So this is 93 minus 522 by 15. So this is minus 429 by 15. Now we calculate CJ minus ZJ. This is 0, 0. So this is 19 by 4. Again a positive value. This is 9 by 5. This is 0. Okay, this value is actually 9 by 15. That is minus 24 by 15. So this is plus 24 by 15. So all the values are greater than or equal to 0. So the solution ends here. So we'll write down, since all CJ minus ZJ are greater than or equal to 0, therefore optimality is reached. And Z minimum or Z optimum here is minus 429 by 15. The value of x1 is 31 by 5 and x2 is 174 by 15. So this is my solution. So with this, I end the session. I hope you have understood the numerical. If you have any doubts, please write to me in the comment section. Don't forget to like, share and subscribe to the channel. Hit the bell icon for latest video updates. See you in the next session. Thank you.